So here is the decision tree philosophy. We saw the problem is we have the attributes like gender and marital status, and we already know whether the customer has ordered the product or not historically based on the attributes gender and marital status. Now in the new data, given the gender, given the marital status, can we guess whether the customer will go ahead and order the product or they will not order the product? This is the original data. Now we can actually rearrange the data like this. So there are 14 data points, you can see them. Some of them are male, some of them are married, some of them are unmarried, some of them are female, again married and unmarried. So we have total 14 customers. 10 customers haven't ordered the product, only 4 customers ordered the product. So no, did not order the product, 10, yes, there are 4 persons who ordered the product. The percentage of yes is 29%, the percentage of no is 71%. So 71% of the customers did not order the product, only 29% of the customers ordered the product. So that's what this indicates at the root, at the population level, at the overall data level, there is 29% order rate. Now when I divide this whole 14 customers into two groups based on gender, there are 8 male, 6 female. So you can see that here, you can count them, there are 8 customers who are male, 6 customers who are female. So there are 8 male customers, 6 female customers. Now let's go into this male customer segment. So out of 14, I have considered 8 customers. So now my focus of the population or my focused segment will be 8 customers only. So I'm considering all the male customers. If I consider all the male customers, out of them 7 have actually did not order anything. Only one male customer ordered the product. Out of all the male, if I take just the male, if I take only one customer ordered, 7 did not order. So the order percentage is 14, did not order percentage is 86. So within male customers, 86% did not order. Within female customers, if I see 3 female customers ordered, 3 female customers did not order. So out of 14, there were 6 female customers. Now my focused segment or my focused data, my focused population or sample is just 6 customers. Out of these 6 customers, 3 have ordered, 3 have not ordered. So yes percentage, yes ordered is 50%, no did not order is 50%. Now let us again go back to my 8 customers, further segment it out. So there is one more variable called marital status. Within 8 male, there are 6 married, 2 unmarried. So within 8 male population, there are 6 married guys, 2 unmarried people. So out of these 6 married people, 6 did not order, 6 out of 6 did not order, and nobody actually ordered. Out of 2 unmarried guys, 1 ordered, 1 did not order. So it matches up. So out of 8, 7 did not order, 1 yes ordered. So out of them, 2 are unmarried. Within unmarried guys, 1 ordered, 1 did not order. So here no percentage, no is 100%. Out of 6 female people, again if I do further segmentation based on marital status, 3 are unmarried, 3 are married. So you can see that out of all the female population, you can see 3 are unmarried, 3 are married. Out of 3 married female population, 3 did not order, 0 ordered. So 3 married female population, none of them ordered. 3 unmarried female population, all of them ordered the product. So our product is ordered by all the female population who are unmarried. So all the unmarried population who are female, they have ordered 100%. So there are only 3 unmarried female customers. There are only 3 unmarried female customers. Let me repeat that once again. You have 6 female customers. Out of them, 3 are unmarried, 3 are married. So there are 3 unmarried female customers. All of them ordered the product. There are 8 male customers. Out of them, 6 are married. So there are 8 male customers, 6 are married. So 6 married male customers, all of them did not order. Okay, so if I see a customer is male and married, I can very confidently say he will not order. If I see a customer is female and unmarried, I will say yes, they will definitely order. If I see male married, I would say no, they'll not order. The new data is asking us if a customer is male, married, then I would say customer male, married, historically 100% of the times they did not order. So the product order, I would say they will not order. Female, unmarried, so female, unmarried, 100% of the times they have ordered. I can guess that they might order for sure. So this new data point belongs to this segment, male married population. This new data point belongs to this segment, female unmarried population. So I would say they will not order the product, male married, female unmarried will order the product. So we can send separate SMSs for these type of populations, these type of segments. Male married guys historically haven't ordered the product. Maybe we can send a different SMS that will actually provoke them, somehow make them buy this product if it is appropriate, or maybe send a different SMS if it is not appropriate. Female unmarried people, they are anyway buying it with higher confidence, then we can do little bit of cross-selling or upselling by sending different offers so that they will buy more. That is what the whole philosophy of decision trees. So what is the decision tree approach here? So the aim is to divide the whole population into segments, and each segment need to be useful for decision making. What do we mean by each segment need to be useful for business decision making? That means the segment need to be pure, or the segment should have one class really dominating. Then it is easy to classify the unknown items. That means if we segment out the whole population into two groups, in one group there should be more buyers, in the other group there should be very less buyers or more non-buyers, then we can actually send a message that is related to more buyers. We can send a message, or it's very easy to make our decision, business easy to apply the business strategy. For example, I mean, it takes no great skill to say a customer has 50% chance of buying, 50% of chance of not buying. Anybody can say that, you know, there is a 50-50% of buying or not buying. A good split is like this. I mean, we give a rule, or we give one particular segmentation criterion and say that gender equal to female customers, they have 5% probability of buying, 95% probability of not buying. That means we have segmented out the whole population into a group where, I mean, two groups where within one group we can actually say there are more buyers, the other group there are lesser buyers. So that is the whole decision tree approach. They divide the whole population into the segments, in which in each segment there is a huge dominancy of a particular class. So example, our sales segmentation based on age. So let us suppose there are 100 customers to start with. Now if I divide based on age, young and old, there are two segments that I am making. So age, young, age, based on age, young customers based on age, old customers. There are 60 young customers, 40 old customers. So out of 100, 60 are young, 40 are old. Now within these 60 young customers, 31 is buying, 29 is not buying. Within these old customers, 19 is buying, 21 is not buying. So at the overall level, I know 50% buying, 50% not buying. Even if I divide them based on age, young customers, within young customers, again it looks like 50-50, nearly 50% buying, 50% not buying. Again in old customers, 50-50, 50% buying, 50% not buying. Then dividing the whole population based on age, doesn't really help us, because we already know 50% of the customers will buy, 50% of the customers don't buy. Then why do we really actually need to segment out this population based on age, young and old? There is absolutely no difference between the buying pattern of young and old. They both have 50% of chances of buying. Now, what is a good segmentation criterion? What is a variable that splits the whole population into two good segments? So here is an example. So the whole population has 100 customers. Out of them, some of them are male, some of them are female. There are 60 male customers, 40 female customers. Within male customers, 60, there are 48 buying, only 12 customers are not buying. Within female customers, there are only two customers buying, 38 customers not buying. If you see, overall out of 50 customers who bought that product, 48 are actually male, only 2 are female. So within male there is 80% chance of buying, within female there is only 5% chance of buying. Now when I divide the whole population based on gender, then I can make really good business inferences. One is that lot of male customers, or most of the buyers are male customers, or most of the non-buyers are female customers, none of the female customers are buying. So dividing the whole population based on gender is actually giving us a better split, or giving us a better intuition to run a business strategy or to run a marketing campaign, rather than dividing them based on age, because be it young or be it old, they are not really different when with respect to buying, whereas being male, being female, they are very different with respect to buying. That is what we have to search for, such variables, gender instead of the variable age. Okay, now the main question is, we are looking for pure segment. So this is a pure segment, be it buying or be it non-buying. So this is a pure segment based on, this is a pure segment based on buying. So most of them are buyers. This is a pure segment with respect to not buying. Most of them are non-buyers. Okay, so we are looking for pure segments. Now dataset has many attributes. It has age, it has gender, it has the place that their customers are coming from, the earlier previous orders, etc., etc. So which is the right attribute for pure segmentation? How do we identify whether age is a good one or not? How do we identify whether gender is a good one or not? Or is there any better attribute that even can make into two good segments? Okay, can we start with any attribute? Okay, which attribute to start with? Is there any best separating criteria for attributes? Customer age can impact the sales, gender can impact the sales, customer place, demographics, etc., etc. Everything, out of all the variables that we have in the data set, we just can't have one or two variables. If there are multiple variables, how do we find out which is the best split attribute? You know, the factor, the variable that is very good at dividing the whole population into two groups that are very pure. By very pure, we mean to say one group is dominated by the one class. If our class variable is buying, not buying, or if our class variable is for marketing, response, not response, which attribute that does a good job of dividing the whole population into pure classes? Here in this example, this is a pure class, most of them are buyers. This is a non-pure class, most of them are non-buyers. So how do we actually find out that attributes? What is the splitting criterion? Which variable I should choose for splitting? What is the splitting criterion?